How do you see things? Where do you see things standing right now? Obviously, the Tea Party has suffered some setbacks since President Obama was reelected. They are now seen as kind of a something of a toxic brand. And yet the Koch brothers march on. They march on in things like their bid for the Tribune Company, which we were talking about on Take Action News just a moment before you joined us. What's next?
I'm a type of person who is not terribly concerned with the rhetoric from certain politicians or from these brands like the Tea Party. I think you have to look at the driving factors. I think the Tea Party is just a means to an end. And the Koch brothers, they understand that the Tea Party brand isn't what it used to be. You know, if you look at where they're spending their money, it's not only on this bid to take over the Tribune Company papers, but they've also infused more money into this group called Generation Opportunity that's now marketing the same types of policies to young people, to 18-year-olds, 19-year-olds, to a group called the Libra Initiative that markets towards Latinos, to a group called the Independent Women's Forum that markets towards women, because they see the demographic shifts in America and they see where they have kind of not sold these policies particularly well, and they're reinvesting and focusing again on just spreading the same tired ideas that they've kind of pushed for 30 years. But again, you know, the Tea Party was just a vehicle for delivering these ideas and delivering certain policy and political goals. It's not an end to itself.
And of course, one of the new vehicles that they're using, Lee, is BuzzFeed. BuzzFeed, a popular website that branched into politics just really for the 2012 election. Before that, they were known for sort of their listicles and top 20 cutest honey badger pictures, cutest kitty pictures. And yet there was BuzzFeed essentially holding an event that was sponsored by the Koch brothers to discuss immigration, and it really only featured conservative or libertarian think tank members. You had been, your work investigating the Koch brothers had been essentially attacked by Ben Smith, the editor, BuzzFeed politics editor, in the past. Here he is now going forward, taking Koch brothers money. This is an issue that's been brought up by Yasha Levine and the Not Safe for Work Corporation. How do you view this? Is BuzzFeed the Koch brothers' latest conquest?
I don't know if conquest is the right word, but you know, you have folks like Ben Smith who have written really inaccurate and dishonest articles in the past, kind of dismissing the Koch brothers' influence. I mean, this claim that he makes that the Koch brothers are not involved in politics for any economic gain is ludicrous if you look at the Koch industry's business model, or you even just take 5 seconds to look at their lobbying agenda, which is, you know, that actually has to be disclosed by the U.S. Senate. So they're obviously obsessed with these laws that affect their bottom line. They're spending millions of dollars on lobbyists.
Well, it's absolutely correct. And one thing that people point out is at the very least, they're getting the charitable tax deduction for donating those monies to those groups. Lee Fong, amazing stuff. You're an amazing reporter. Follow him on Twitter at LHFong, F-A-N-G. And of course, stuff on The Nation. Lee, thanks so much for joining us. And read his book, The Machine.
Hey, Daniel, you're the man. Thanks for having me.
All right, Lee. Coming up next, David Schuster is going to retake the mic when Take Action News continues after this.